Today, a very big Bollywood actor, Sushant Singh Rajput, he committed suicide. He was having a very high IITJ rank and he studied from DC, Delhi College of Engineering. So you can see that what is the value of money, power, fame, being a hero of this world? What is the value of so-called education? Externally, we are following our so-called heroes, but they are absolutely frustrated in their lives beyond imagination. One can have millions of fans in Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, but no true friend. This is the result of godless civilization. People feel that everything is finished at death. They can escape every suffering just by, committing suicide. They do not know the concept of soul. And when you talk about law of karma, then they say it's simply mythology. It is useless. In our education system, we are not putting the importance of the Vedic scriptures, especially Bhagavad Gita. And deliberately, the Vedic scriptures are put forward as mythology. The Bhagavad Gita is telling so much about the science of the mind, science of the soul. Is it a fairy tale story? Is it a mythology? We are denying it. We are simply spoiling the future of our nation by denying the access of Vedic scriptures to the future generation of our nation. Previous days, even the films you could see, these films used to be based on the lives of Krishna, Ram, and the avatars and different great devotees. And we didn't see such cases of suicides being done by the film actresses or actors in the previous times because the society was centered around God. Today's films are simply based on wine, woman, sex affair, money, power, all these things. Indians are simply imitating the West, simply imitating America and the Western countries. And what is the result? Increase in divorce rate? Increase in suicide, increase in drug addiction, increase in violence, increase in illicit sex affair. That's what we want? That's the advancement? We should put forward this question very much within our lives and we should see where we are going wrong. We should now focus on the real treasure of India, the treasure of Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, and see how we can change this world, how we can really change our own life at first, then we'll see that what is the great contribution. We Indians are very fortunate because we have taken birth in the land of spirituality. But unfortunately, we have forgotten our spiritual roots. And that is why, simply imitating the West, we are suffering. We are sitting on a bed of jewels, but we are begging for few pieces of glass. That is our unfortunate position. We should now turn back our attention towards our very roots, the roots of Vedic wisdom, which forms the basis of India. And that is why India is famous all over the world. India is not famous for technology. India is not famous for economy in the whole world. So we should see that why India is famous in this world for our Vedic scriptures, for our spiritual roots. So therefore, it's high time that we learn and again, see what wisdom our Vedic scriptures can give us and turn our attention back towards Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, Mahabharata, Ramayana, and we'll see that how the society will progress and it will lead towards happiness. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.